Well, thank you. Okay, if you haven't heard of it yet, you will. It's called Diabesity. If current trends continue, by 2030, 44% of Americans will be obese, and obesity will contribute to 6 million new cases of type 2 diabetes in the next 20 years. Alarming numbers. Dr. Robert Eager from the Queens Medical Center has more in this morning's Ask a Specialist segment. Good morning to you, Doctor.
Good morning.
What is diabesity?
So diabesity is when a patient is obese and develops diabetes because of the obesity.
Okay, so it has to be in that order, if you will.
Mm-hmm.
Because a lot of folks, as we know, unfortunately, we have obesity as an issue, and a lot of folks in Hawaii especially have diabetes.
Yes. So, unfortunately, the trend is that already in 2013,
wow,
almost 9% of the population in Hawaii have diabetes. And almost 20% of the population is obese.
And so we're seeing a graphic here of how that trend is continuing, if you will, and those are alarming numbers, Doc.
They are, and you can see from 1994, you see a darkening in the red. The red is a higher percentage of both obesity and diabetes.
What are some of the signs? Symptoms.
Some signs and symptoms. I mean, for obesity, it's enlargement of your waistline, gaining weight. Symptoms of diabetes is frequent thirst, frequent urination, feeling fatigued all the time.
When you say about excessive thirst, how does that come about? I mean, is it when you're exercising or just when you're standing still?
Just day to day.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, we want to prevent this, obviously, or stop diabetes. How do we do that?
So the important thing is to lose weight, to be active on a daily basis. And another important way of treating or managing diabetes is bariatric surgery. Bariatric surgery is the only way we have to actually cure type 2 diabetes in obese patients.
So that is not, sometimes we talk about surgery being the last alternative. In this case?
In this case, there isn't a medicine that works as well.
Okay. Well, that's scary.
Yeah.
Okay, so what can we do now? Change our diets, exercise more. But if these numbers continue, how do we get a hold of this and make sure that our next generation, if you will, doesn't have this as an issue even more?
Well, that's why we have to start changing how we live.
Yeah.
We cannot no longer eat whatever we want, eat mindlessly. We need to start looking at eating in an intellectual way. We need to start being more active. And that way your children and your children's children do not have this problem.
And break that cycle. To learn more about diabetes, you can join Dr. Robert Eager along with Dr. Alan Parsa and Dr. Cedric Lorenzo, the Queens Medical Center, for a free Speaking of Health lecture. The topic, diabetes, the new epidemic. That's going to happen on Wednesday, Doctor, right?
That's correct.
October 28th starts at 5:30, continues to about 7 over at the Queens Punch Bowl campus. To register, go to a link at k212.com for much more. It's become an epidemic. Thank you, Dr. Mason.
Thank you.
Nice to talk to you. All right, top stories of the morning are